Good morning. Sunday has come, thank God. And this particular Sunday we are observing as the third Sunday in Lent. We'll follow the order of worship today that you'll find in your printed service folder. And our service today begins with our opening hymn. Hymn number 259. Please note the verses. We'll sing verses 1 through 3 and verse 5. Please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Beloved in the Lord, Let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins to God our Father, beseeching him in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. I said, I will confess my transgressions to the Lord, and you forgave the iniquity of my sin.
O Almighty God, merciful Father, I, a poor, miserable sinner, confess to you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserved your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them. And I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful being. I now ask each of you, in the presence of God who searches the heart, do you confess that you have sinned and you repent of your sins?
I do.
Do you believe that Jesus Christ has redeemed you from all your sins and you desire forgiveness in his name?
I do.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of God's word, announce the grace of God to each of you. And in the stead and by the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. May he comfort your heart by his holy absolution and strengthen you by his sacraments, that your joy may be full. Peace be with you. Amen. My eyes are ever toward the Lord, for he shall pluck my feet from the net. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. O my God, I trust in you. Turn yourself to me and have mercy on me. I am desolate and afflicted. Please be seated.
The Lord be with you. Let us all pray. We beseech thee, Almighty God, look upon the hearty desires of thy humble servants, and stretch forth the right hand of thy majesty to be our defense against all our enemies. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, ever one God, world without end.
The Old Testament lesson appointed for the third Sunday in Lent is written in 2 Samuel chapter 22. We read there verses 1 through 7. It's written, David spoke to the Lord the words of this song on the day when the Lord delivered him from the hand of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul. He said, "The Lord is my rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold and my refuge, my Savior. You save me from violence. I call upon the Lord who is worthy to be praised, and I am saved from my enemies. For the waves of death encompassed me. The torrents of destruction assailed me. The cords of Sheol entangled me. The snares of death confronted me. In my distress, I called upon the Lord. To my God, I called. From his temple, he heard my voice, and my cry came to his ears." This is the Old Testament lesson. Thanks be to God. The psalmody for today. "Unto you I lift up my eyes, O you who dwell in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look to the hand of their masters, as the eyes of a maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God until he has mercy on us. Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy on us, for we are exceedingly filled with contempt." Ephesians chapter 5, reading there verses 1 through 9. It's written, "Be imitators of God as beloved children, and walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself up for us, a fragrant offering and sacrifice to God. But sexual immorality and all impurity or covetousness must not even be named among you, as is proper among saints. Let there be no filthiness, nor foolish talk, nor crude joking, which are out of place. But instead, let there be thanksgiving. For you may be sure of this, that everyone who is sexually immoral or impure, or who is covetous, that is, an idolater, has no inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and God. Let no one deceive you with empty words, for because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. Therefore, do not become partners with them. For at one time you were darkness, but now you are light in the Lord. Walk as children of light, for the fruit of light is found in all that is good and right and true. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God." Oh, come, let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the founder and perfecter of our faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, despising the shame,
and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God.
The Holy Gospel for the third Sunday in Lent is written in St. Luke chapter 11, and we read there verses 14 through 28.
"Glory be to you, O Lord."
As you are able, please rise and honor the gospel of our Lord Jesus. And these verses will also serve as the basis for our sermon this morning. It's written, "Now Jesus was casting out a demon that was mute. When the demon had gone out, the mute man spoke, and the people marveled. But some of them said, 'He casts out demons by Beelzebul, the prince of demons,' while others, to test him, kept seeking from him a sign from heaven. But he, knowing their thoughts, said to them, 'Every kingdom divided against itself is laid waste, and a divided household falls. And if Satan also is divided against himself, how will his kingdom stand? For you say that I cast out demons by Beelzebul. And if I cast out demons by Beelzebul, by whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore, they will be your judges. But if it is by the finger of God that I cast out demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you. When a strong man, fully armed, guards his own palace, his goods are safe. But when one stronger than he attacks him and overpowers him, he takes away his armor in which he trusted and divides his spoil. Whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. When the unclean spirit has gone out of a person, it passes through waterless places seeking rest, and finding none, it says, I will return to my house from which I came. And when it comes, it finds the house swept and put in order. Then it goes and brings seven other spirits more evil than itself, and they enter and dwell there. Then the last state of that person is worse than the first. As he said these things, a woman in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, Blessed is the womb that bore you and the breasts at which you nursed. But he said, Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and keep it. Here ends the Holy Gospel.
Praise be to you.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made. Being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory, to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Please be seated. Our chief hymn for today is hymn number 18. We pray. Oh, Almighty God, most merciful Father, we give you thanks and praise for the word of forgiveness and life which you have caused to be announced to us anew today. Bless us by it, and through your grace, deliver us from all the devil's wiles. Keep us for eternal life. Be with and bless and help us. To that end, may the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. O God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. In the name of Jesus, grace to you and peace from him who casts out uncleanness so that you may speak again. Grace, mercy, and peace are yours from God the Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord Jesus said, when a strong man fully armed guards his own palace, his goods are safe. And some of his goods are things that he likes to kick around. And some are things, perhaps, that he prefers to ignore. And some things, perhaps, are things that he finds different uses for. But they are all safe in his possession. And in the description that Jesus gives, the man is strong. The man is fully armed. And the man guards his own house. And here, the house that Jesus has in mind is a kingdom governed by wisdom that even the devil himself and all of his minions have, that a divided household falls. And if the glue that holds the kingdom together is a common enemy, maybe that's enough. And maybe that's all you need. And now from the vast empire of devils, which Jesus likens to a huge household, now we come down and we zero in, so to speak, and our text begins with a man whose mouth was held shut, and the devil was inhabiting him like a house. Sometimes, because of devils, people's minds are troubled. There's spiritual and mental and emotional and physical troubles. Somehow they all overlap. And sometimes those who are troubled in this way, sometimes they harm themselves, and sometimes they cry out and exhibit great strength to hurt themselves and others. You can read about it in the Gospels. Sometimes the devil finds different uses for them. But still, in a vast house like this, a fallen world like a vast house, the strong man guards his own palace, and his goods are safe. Ownership helps us, I think, to understand some things. For one thing, it's hard to trust someone else with things that are yours to help you keep it, to help you take care of it, to help you make improvements on it, because it's not theirs. It's not theirs, so why should they care? Ownership is also why it's hard to help your neighbor improve and protect his property and business. After all, it's not yours. And of course, right, you care because you know you should. But at the same time, perhaps we realize when we think about it, we're not concerned with it all that much. But for your neighbor and for love of him, you should be concerned for him. You only should. And if you ever had something that you'd rather it be destroyed than have someone take it from you, if someone else had something that you would rather see destroyed than that they should keep it and they have it and you don't, then that's sin, and you begin to taste guilt and fear of death. And in just that way, the strong man guards his own palace and his goods are safe. Until the Lord Jesus says, someone stronger than he. The writer to the Hebrews declares this mystery to us in chapter 2. Since therefore the children share in flesh and blood, he himself likewise partook of the same things, that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is the devil, and deliver all those who through fear of death were subject to lifelong slavery. When Jesus, the stronger one, comes from heaven into the flesh, when he was made man, then came all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, even hidden in such weakness and such poverty and such lowliness. And now you find him in the gospel so touchable and so approachable and so able to be challenged that they challenge him and they say to him that he's in league with Satan, and they test him, demanding signs from heaven. But over and over again, you know who knew who he was. The devils, they knew him, they recognized him, and they trembled before him. The stronger one attacks and overcomes, and he takes away the strong man's armor in which he trusted, and what comes next, he divides up the spoil. And that attack comes, and you experience it gently, and you experience it with such kindness, like someone breaking open the door and rescuing you from a hostage situation. The attack comes when Jesus, with his word, appears. And he overcomes. And he overwhelms your unbelief. And he drives the devil from you. And you were held so tightly, you didn't even know it. But God's own law, the devil was holding over you. And sin and death he held over your head. And all this the Lord Jesus takes away from him by the word of his cross. And so, when you look to Jesus, and when you see him suspended on the cross, who was really attacking who? And who was overcoming on that day? But St. Paul wrote, all who have sinned without the law also perish without the law, and all who have sinned under the law will be judged by the law. But now the righteousness of God has been manifested apart from the law. And the sound of it is the door breaking in, and light comes pouring into the room, and it makes you squint, because when you're in the darkness, that's what light does to you. But behind your hand, and with the agitated dust, right, flying all around you in the brightness, who is it, and what does he want? But law and sin and death and whatever armor the devil trusted, he comes and takes away, the one who takes away the sin of the world and reconciles us to God by his death, to divide the spoils with you. Be careful then, for Jesus warns us in the text, whoever is not with me is against me, and whoever does not gather with me scatters. And then he shows us that when the unclean spirit has gone out of a person, it passes through waterless places seeking rest, finding none, it says, I will return to my house from which I came. And this is true. Demons can be exorcised. Bad habits can be replaced with better ones. Patterns of destruction and dysfunction, those behaviors can be overwritten. And even troubling thoughts can be replaced. But if the house is swept clean, put in order, and then left vacant, who is waiting to move right back in? The Lord Jesus said in John 14, if anyone loves me, He will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him and make our home with him. And that is the word that you keep by faith. And that word that you keep and that word that you love is this: in Jesus, all your sin is forgiven. He forgives you for the selfish jealousy with which you guarded whatever he placed in your hands. He forgives you for failing to care about your neighbor, your brother, his losses and his needs. He forgives you for your quarrelsome destructiveness. You've got it. I've got it too. But he has taken it all away and atoned for it through the cross, through his perfect suffering and death. And he has put it off of you and washed you clean in baptism and restored you at his word. You stand forgiven. And the gospel that he declares and causes to be declared throughout the house: for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. It's just how it is with us, and why it is that we find ourselves dying people and people with burdened consciences and uncertainty and sadness. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a propitiation, as a payment by his blood to be received by faith. And so it is God in Jesus who calls you and compels you without coercing you, but draws you. Come to me, you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Questions maybe come up with a text like this. Questions about devils and about exorcisms. But hopefully, all the big ones, the really big questions, are answered for you in your hearts. Blessed are not the rich, the beautiful, the successful, but blessed are they who hear the word of God and keep it. Blessed are you who have his word and keep it by faith. Blessed are you, his believers. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through faith in Christ Jesus our Savior. Amen. As you are able, please rise for the singing of the offertory verse, page 7 in your bulletin. O Lord God, Heavenly Father, you have sent your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to take upon himself our flesh, that he might overcome the devil and defend us poor sinners against the adversary. We give thanks to you for your merciful help, and we beseech you to attend us with your grace in all time of temptation, to preserve us from being secure in the flesh, and by your Holy Spirit, keep us in your word and in your fear, that we may be delivered from the enemy and finally obtain eternal salvation through the same your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one true God, now and forever. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up unto the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is good and right so to do. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, gave thanks, and gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. This do as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. O Christ, the Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy upon us.
O Christ, the Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy upon us. O Christ, the Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world.
Please be seated. And those who are coming forward for Holy Communion may do so at this time, row by row. Come, for all things are now ready.
Thank you.
Our crucified and risen Lord Jesus Christ, who has now bestowed upon you his holy body and precious blood, whereby he has made full satisfaction for all your sins, strengthen and preserve you in true faith unto life everlasting. Be filled with joy. Your sins are forgiven. Peace be with you. Amen. Please join with me now in singing the Nunc Dimittis.
You let your servant depart in
O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good,
and his mercy endures forever.
We give thanks to you, O Almighty God, that you've refreshed us through these your salutary gifts. And we beseech you that of your mercy you would strengthen us through the same in faith toward you and in fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one true God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please rise.
The Lord be with you. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up his countenance upon thee and give thee peace.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hymn 596.
To thee.
Blessed Jesus, Son of God.
Please be seated. Once again, everyone, good morning. Thank you, everybody, for the chance to be together here in God's house. And God bless you by all the things that you've heard and received from the dear Lord Jesus today. Just a couple things to bring to your attention now that we've come to the end of our service. To begin with, on the very back page of your bulletin is the congregation praise. It's something you can take and use for devotions at home. Modify it however you might like to. And on the page right before that are the announcements for what's going on here at Redeemer this week. So let's bring these things up one by one, real briefly. First of all, as far as our schedule for today is concerned, Sunday school and adult Bible study will get started at 10:30. And so everybody's invited to stay. If you want, even if you want to just come down there and spend a little time together, visit with one another, have a little something to eat and a little something to drink. There are refreshments down there, and I hope that you'll take advantage of that. Spend a little time together, and then Sunday school and adult Bible class will get started here at half past. On Wednesday this week, we will upload the next of our midweek Lenten devotionals, which, by the way, I want to say thank you to everybody for the way that those have been so well received. It looks like people are watching them, and so I'm grateful to you for watching those, our midweek Lenten devotionals that we're uploading on Wednesday. So those are at our YouTube channel online. And on Thursday, we'll have our virtual Bible class on Skype once again at 7 p.m. Next Sunday, God willing, our worship service at 9 o'clock with Sunday school and adult Bible class at 10:30. A couple of other things that I want to make sure to bring to your attention. First of all, February went remarkably quickly, and I can't believe how fast it went. Even though we got an extra day, February went fast, and so it occurs to me that I owe y'all a newsletter for March. Okay, so it's coming. I'll get it out to you as quick as I can. But in the meantime, keep track of your bulletins and watch for your stuff coming out by email and so forth, so you know what's going on here at Redeemer in the days and weeks ahead. Also, there is here for you, I ordered some invitations, okay? The invitation, the big idea is that the invitation is going to match the banner that goes outside, which now, by the way, Jim, I ordered a second one, right? So we got two banners that are going to go outside inviting our neighbors to join us for Easter service. And we have a postcard mailing that is going out to our immediate vicinity. About 4,000 homes will be getting postcard invitations to join us for Easter. And those are all supposed, they all kind of look, they look alike. They're matched. So the banner outside will match the postcard mailing, which will match a little invitation that I had made up for you. This is what it looks like. And if you'd like to go ahead and grab a handful of these, let's wallpaper Scottsdale with these invitations to join us. It says on one side, I know that my Redeemer lives. And on the other side, join us for Holy Easter Day. And it's got the information on the service, the Bible study, and the breakfast that we'll be doing that day. I took my first look at that, and I thought, well, that's funny looking. And then I looked at it again, and I thought, no, this is the most functional invitation I've ever seen. You can hand this to somebody and say, here, read it, and then put your drink on it. And it works perfectly. And so you could please grab a stack of these and use them if you would. I think they're fantastic. I think they look kind of sharp. So if you want to go ahead and grab some of those, they're available for you in the table back in the narthex. I think that's everything I got right now for announcements, unless there's anything I may have been forgotten or needs yet to be mentioned. Okay. Thank you, everybody, again, for the chance to be with you and share God's word with you. God's peace and blessings to all of you until we meet again, and God grant it. I'll see you Sunday.